All right, my name is Sean Kim. I'm part of the tech team. So I do FYI, pull, social, and I go tech running. And I make Live at 5 possible.
Hi, my name is Daniel, and I'm part of the tech team. I go outside into classrooms and fix their projectors, computers, printers, and things like that.
Hi, my name is Devin, and I work for the Tesla tech team. And what I do is I go on the social media apps, and I just look up pictures for the social and all. And yeah, that's what I do.
Because it's the presidential inauguration, so that's exciting. Please ease your stress by using a box and screaming. And this is a true brotherly love story.
Don't say his name, don't even think it. You guys might already know what I'm talking about, but I'm gonna talk more about it in my You Heard Here report.
Hold on.
Cover your ears, she's gonna say a pun.
This one's awful, okay? Let's all New Jersey what the weather is today. But
was their pun bad? I don't know. I was covering my ears. But anyways, I have a guest on today. He's a little feisty. And so yeah, I'll be back with that.
We'll be back with that and more on the other side of the break. Welcome back for the break. Now it's time for the Tesla play-by-play. Yesterday was the blast from the past winter dance. The students dressed like 60s, 70s, and 80s and had a blast.
Hello guys, Marissa Hernandez here, and today we're at the winter dance. What do you say you guys are doing? Welcome to the winter dance again.
Oh, don't you dare look back. Just keep your eyes on me. I said you're holding back. She said shut up.
Oh, what's your name?
Jared.
How do you like to dance so far?
It's good.
When you come to these dances, what do you look forward to?
The food.
I'm doing good.
What are you here with today?
All my friends, Nico.
You guys having fun today?
Yeah.
How much fun? Let's go. 1 to 10. How much fun are you guys having?
9.
She took my arm. I don't know how it happened. We took the front. She said.
How long does it take to prepare this dance and how to organize these dances you have?
It takes about 2 weeks to prepare a dance. ASB does a lot of approvals. We have a meeting beforehand. We vote on what the spirit week is going to be. And then I'm in charge of ordering all the supplies. And then for about a week, the students are making flyers, getting posters, getting everything turned out, passed out to the students. And then the week of the dance, they're out taking spirit counts and they're getting the auditorium ready. So just about 2 weeks.
Are you proud of what your students have accomplished?
Absolutely. This is an awesome year for ASB and they've been doing a great job.
Thank you. Well, that's it for today, guys. It was so fun here. The dance was really good. You guys should come to the next dance. Well, I'll see you then, guys. Marisa Hernandez here, signing out.
For anyone looking to learn a different language, Mandarin Club will start this month on the 26th at lunch in room 205. The club will allow you to learn Mandarin in a fun way while also learning about the Chinese culture. All students who speak Chinese or those who want to learn are welcome. And for anyone looking to be an engineer as a career, then robotics and engineering class might be for you. The ABC Education Foundation is hosting a robotics class for 7th and 8th graders. Students will use top-tier VEX robotic parts and finest coding software to create robots. Even if you have no experience at all, you will be able to do projects that match your own level of skill. Classes start on the 30th through March 1st, Mondays through Wednesdays, 2:30 through 4:30. Classes start at $220. Let's check out the Test Off calendar. Today is College Day and Minimum Day. Now it's time for the Action Reaction.
We are back with another amazing Magic Action Reaction segment. Today we have for you Magician Smoothini, where he takes cards out from thin air and from inside his mouth.
That's all I have.
I know how he does that.
Magic that happens close to your face is that it has to be performed exquisitely.
Okay, yes. Pronounce that word correctly, but...
Excuse me.
Just caught the card.
But honestly, just do not like card tricks because
that's amazing.
Do something to you, Miss Mel. B.
Oh, wow.
That my little boy likes. Can I see your hand? The other side. Thank you. Oh, perfect. I'm gonna take this ball, put it right about here. I want you to hold that ball real tight for me. Thank you. With that ball there and that ball there, we're gonna go abracadabra. Open up your hand.
Shut up! Shut up!
Let me mentally assault you two on the other hand.
Awesome. Did you know that Smoothini went up to the semifinals in America's Got Talent Season 9? Well, we will see you next time with more magic segments.
That concludes the Tetzloff Play-by-Play, and we'll see you after the break. Welcome back. Time to get into today's hot topics. The King of the Seven Seas was introduced to the movie Batman v Superman, released on October 5th, 2016. Aquaman, played by Jason Momoa, protects the world from the Atlanteans revolting. The Surface Dwellers is originally planned to be released on July with an underwater adventure. It will be directed by James Wan. Fans will blow away to see the new addition to the DC Universe. Relieving stress is really difficult, but with the Screenbox, stress relief is made easier. The screen box is made out of foam inside of the box, which absorbs 90% of the noise. On the outside, there is a high-strength polymer shell. Based on the research, 25% of stress is reduced every scream let out. The screen box can be shipped out anywhere around the world. All right, you heard it here with Jace. What do you have for us today?
Hello guys, Bye Bye Man. I was reading up on the Bye Bye Man, and you're supposed to not say his name and not even think about him. Bye Bye Man is the reason for all man's unspeakable acts. That's what these main characters, has a 3 out of 10 star. IMDb, and the reviews are. I'm still probably gonna see it, but it's, people have not liked it. I'm just gonna say that, but it still looks like a good movie. I'm gonna give it a shot. Most of you will probably to give it a shot as well. So go check out Bye Bye Man. It's in theaters now. That's it for my You Hear It Here report. It's time for Jenna with weather. Good morning, Jenna.
Time for today's weather report. Starting off, good morning everyone, and it's time for today's weather report. Starting off in Tokyo, Japan, they'll be seeing a low of 35 degrees. Moving all the way to the other side of the map, all the way at the bottom, Rio de Janeiro will be seeing a low of 75. Slowly moving back up to the top, Los Angeles will be seeing a low of 52, and all the way back at the top in Anchorage, they'll be seeing a low of negative 9. On to our highest map, Tokyo will be seeing a low of 51. Moving to the other side of the map, all the way at the top, Anchorage will be seeing a high of 10. Slowly moving back down, Los Angeles will be seeing a high of 59, and in Rio de Janeiro, 86. The winter was difficult on the plants, but in the spring, they will be relieved. The calendar is a great reminder of spring. The bright yellow coin-shaped center and the golden petals make it one of the prettiest flowers. It doesn't take a lot of care and blooms best in color in temperatures, in cooler temperatures. Can't even history sometimes.
Do you
but
know all of
the sports
faces?
With Jameson? Good morning.
So
can't even history
I don't.
Sometimes.
But
now it's time for sports with Jameson. There is good morning.
George Washington there.
Can't even history sometimes.
Maybe Abraham Lincoln, I think I
but
saw him
on
the right.
But now it's time for sports with Jameson.
No guess.
Good morning.
I can't even history,
sometimes.
But now it's time
but
for sports
now
with Jameson.
For sports with Jameson.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Oh, well there we are. Just couldn't see us there for a second, but this is Dylan. He's a producer of the show.
Yes.
I think, right? And so, let me scoot over here a little bit. Yeah, there you go. So who do you think is gonna win the Super Bowl?
Just saying, the Steelers are gonna win. Anyone who does not think so is either does not watch football or not a Steelers fan.
All right, so he thinks the Steelers are gonna win. I know my friend Manoj is probably not that happy about it.
Sorry, Manoj.
He says no hard feelings. But the Steelers are going to kill the Deflategate. And, but who do you think is going to win for the NFC? I'm hoping the Packers do. I mean, the Falcons are a good team, but I hope the Packers and the Steelers go. That would be a good Super Bowl.
Yeah, maybe. That would be cool.
Yeah. And this guy, he is a Rockets fan, right?
Yes, Rockets. Go James Harden.
He wants them to get to the playoffs. And, yeah. But... let's talk about Golden State. Golden State had a 24-point lead against the Grizzlies, but then turned into a 2-point lead because Curry and KD could not pass the ball to each other. And then finally, KD took the ball down the court, dribbled down the clock, and choked on a 20-foot three. And hey, if you're gonna be a hero, it's most likely you're gonna fail. But but the Cowboys get roasted pretty bad because. The book said, the Cowboys may sell the most jerseys and have a cool stadium plus a quotable owner, but they can't be America's team if you have not been to the Super Bowl in 21 years. Yeah, like, come on.
21 years.
And think about all of those three things and they've never been to the Super Bowl.
That's crazy.
You should have ditched Romo a long time ago. But that's it for today. Time for the news.
Nice. And Danielle, who's our guest today?
Well, today we have Shanai. Shanai's in my math class.
Hi. Well, let's get into the first story. Today we will mark the inauguration of the 45th President of the United States of America, Donald Trump. There are many mixed feelings about this day, as some have different opinions on being elected as president among U.S. citizens. The inauguration will consist of a luncheon as well as Trump's presidential speech. Trump's inauguration will last from Thursday night to Saturday morning. A Nigerian fighter jet operation took a turn for the worse. The fighter failed to hit the terrorist group called Boko Haram and hit the Nigerian refugee camp. This camp was for internally displaced people and workers. Although there were no official death toll and the aid workers reported that more than 50 people killed, hopefully this experience will teach people to be more careful. So how do you think the leader of this operation reacted when he heard about the news?
No, I mean, there's different ways to react to this type of thing.
I think he would be like really upset about it because it's a camp of people who can't really help themselves, and then 50 people died.
It's just sad.
Yes. What do you think?
It's sad. Yeah.
Okay, well that wraps it up for the news. It's time for today's segment where you show the world what they have. On June 22, 2014, former Baylon University basketball player Isaiah Austin found out he was diagnosed with Marfan syndrome. Since the arteries in his heart were unusually large and the risk of high rupturing if he continued to play, he could no longer play at a competitive level. Adam Silver, commissioner of the NBA, invited Isaiah to the 2014 NBA draft. In the middle of the 15th and the 16th picks, Adam made Isaiah a ceremonial pick in the draft. As Isaiah walked up to the podium, the crowd gave him a standing ovation. This was a dream come true. Recently, Isaiah Austin was medically cleared and now is able to play basketball at a competitive level. So, Danielle, fill us in on the status of this week's weather.
Again, we have with us Shanai. Good morning, Shanai.
Good morning.
Will you please read this week's web poll for us?
Should the wall be built on the USA, the US and Mexico border?
Here's what you guys. Yes, because America would never populate and American would have less varieties of jobs.
Another fan said,
no, because people from Mexico wouldn't be able to have a free life. They would want to live. To vote,
visit us online at ungba.com.
You could visit us at any place. On Instagram at Ungba Global. A comment with us at either place and your message might just make it on it. So Shanai, what do you think?
I don't think he should build the wall between US and Mexico.
Okay, now for Ian. Well, that's all the time we have for today. We'll see you next week.